Hello, my name is Aniruddha. Today we'll discuss official support of Kotlin to the Android. Recently, just 3 or 4 days ago, Google has officially supported Kotlin as a programming language to the Android. Here you may find that document. They have said many things over here. You may, if you are more interested, go on reading this thing. They even launched, what you can say, they are launching Studio 3.0, which will give you full-fledged support to the Kotlin. So here is the official page where you can see Kotlin is supported to the Android. Then this is a Kotlin programming language page where you will find they have given some support for the Android over here. You may see this thing, right? Here you may see this thing. So many things they have discussed over here, how to create the activities, how to convert existing Java activity or existing Java code to the Kotlin. Everything is full-fledged working in this canary version of the studio. If you want to start, or if you are early adopter and if you want to start with the Kotlin, just click on the get started with the Kotlin, and here Kotlin is fully supported in Android Studio 3.0 over here. You may see this thing, or go to this website and download Android Studio from here. I have already downloaded over here, and many things are same. If you are existing Android developer, you will find multiple things are extremely same. So difference is just with regardless to the Kotlin programming. So what I am going to do is that just create new project. Can you see this tab or this checkbox is very new over here, right? Include the Kotlin support. So I'm going to change the name, say Kotlin app, right? I would be saying Kotlin app. Remember that you have checked this, otherwise your code would be normal, or your project would be the normal Java project. So I'm not going to go in the discussion of Java is a best or Kotlin is a best. That is another debate part. I'm not going to discuss that thing at all. So for that, you may read many blogs are there. Many people are talking about this thing. But intention of this tutorial would be how to deal with the Kotlin in the Android Studio. Just a next over here. So here you may find some new things in the studio, like Android things, which is related to the IoT. Right, this has been added over here. Still Android Auto is not fully supported, and these things are same. If you have worked with the Android before this, all these things are extremely same. So what I'm going to do is that just select the phone and tablet for now and say next over here, right? Then I would be selecting empty activity from this template, just say next, and here whatever main activity, or you can change the name here, you can change the name. Just say finish. Once you say finish over here, it would be creating new Kotlin app. So that would look like this thing, right? That absolutely will look like this thing. So very same, right? Just few things has been added over there. Just go to your root Gradle, right? You might want to go to the root Gradle, and into this root Gradle you'll find, just it is completing in a few minutes. So Gradle file has been changed. Here they have given everything. Where are the changes, or how exactly that would be starting? Well, that's very good. Project has been completed, and if I switch to the project mode here, and from the project mode go to the root level Gradle, you will find these plugins. So this plugin has been upgraded over here, right? Please check the version of the Gradle plugin and new plugin version over here, or new plugin they have added, like this Kotlin Gradle plugin. So I'm going to show you apps Gradle file over here. Here you might find that one new plugin has been applied, one binary plugin they have applied over here, which is nothing but Kotlin Android. And here one dependency is there. If you find that dependency over here, right? This dependency is very much important if you want to work with the Kotlin, right? That's nice. If I open activity, how it looks like? See this. So activity is looking like, remember that this is a Kotlin syntax, you may find. So extends is replaced by something, this new syntax, right? Is a relationship they have presented in this manner, right? Overriding of the method will go something like this, and this is your bundle. So if you are already Android programmer, you might be knowing all these things. What is on create is one of the lifecycle hook, right? Then set content view, it is going to pick the content, or it is going to parse this activity underscore XML, right? That things have not been changed, right? XML have not been changed, but some modifications are there. We'll discuss that as well. So presently what I'm going to do is that instead of this text view, let me have button, right? Instead of this text view, let me make it as button, right? I have created simple as a button, and here you can say okay, name would be okay. Let me assign ID, right? Let me assign the ID, and at plus ID I can say btn okay. Remember that I'm not explaining what Android is, I'm explaining how you are going to deal with the Kotlin. So if you want to see what is Android and what all are tutorials, kindly subscribe our channel, CodeKul channel, where you will find detailed course on the Android, right? Here we are just discussing brand new features for the Kotlin, right? So I have this thing, right? I have this thing already. It is a constraint layout, very new feature of the layout system. So btn okay is there. Now what I want to do is that, so you might have did this thing already, right? But you are going to see how these things are going to work. See, I'm going to say btn okay, then you would be having our brand method, which is nothing but find view by id, and you are going to say r dot id dot btn okay as button, right? This is a Kotlin syntax, no semicolon, you don't need semicolon over here, right? Just say btn okay, find view by id as button. Now I want to set on click listener, btn okay dot set on click listener, right? Dot set on click listener, and that's it. So whatever you will type over here, you don't need to have set on click listener, then anonymous inner type, right? Or you don't need to create one class which is implementing that anonymous inner class, no, absolutely, or that inner class view dot on click listener, no. Just btn okay dot set on click listener, that's it. And here what I'm going to do is that log, let me type the log dot I, right? Rest of the things are same. Let's import that, and I'm going to say at CodeKul, and here I can say hello or welcome, no semicolon, right? We are too habitual of typing that, but you don't need to have the semicolon, right? So if you click on this, this message should be printed. Emulator I have already started, let me run the code. You will find what happens if I run the code. So pretty straight, right? Very simple, very simple. So nothing fancy over here, you just created one button, but this is very new to you, right? You might not have seen this thing or this thing, right? Or this thing, right? So this is related to the Kotlin. Now when you click on the btn okay, you need to see one log, not profiler, you just need to see the log. Let me click on the logcat, right, and open it. Here you can see, can you see, welcome, it is printing. So this is very nice code, or very simple code to understand, right? Now I want to create new activity, or what if I have existing activity, what should I do? So let me create the activity first over here, say simple activity, and source language, can you see over here, if you want to create new activity, right, if you want to create new activity, make sure that your source language is either Java or Kotlin, or only two options are there. If you say Kotlin, right, it will create new activity in the Kotlin language, right? if you have what we are discussing, that what if I have existing activity and I want to convert that activity, right? If I have existing activity and I want to convert that activity to the Kotlin, that feature is also provided by Studio. So many features has been added. See, it is your plain Java activity. Now if you think that you want to convert this to the Kotlin, what you would be doing, just go to the code and can you see this convert Java file to the Kotlin file. Just click on this and see, this magic happens and you will see your Java activity has been converted to the Kotlin activity, right? So many things are there, many features are there. One more feature of Studio, let me show you. I have one Java class, right? And I can say util, name of my class would be the util, and into the util there is one method, say public void, and the parse would be the method. So whatever JSON I'm going to parse it in the string format, that JSON, it would be the parsing, right? It would be parsing. Now I want this much method, right, into my one of the activity, and let me paste that. But see, that is a Java method and you are pasting in the Kotlin code. So what happened? Can you see, the moment you are going to paste it, Studio is going to suggest you clipboard content is of Java, do you want to convert it? If you say yes, automatically that method would be getting converted to the Kotlin code, right? So this is the power of the Studio, right? So programming aspects of the Kotlin can be discussed in the another tutorial, but presently my intention, right, to show you how exactly future would be, right? You may need to develop your Android application into this programming language, which is Kotlin. But don't worry, that's very simple. If you are going to see my tutorials, you would be understanding all that things. And if you want to learn the Android, kindly subscribe my CodeKul channel and you would be having detailed Android tutorial. Okay, now what I would be showing another thing is that very powerful thing that would be very interesting. Just go to here, right, and I'm going to show you Kotlin for Android. Just scroll it down, right? So what they did is that they have added some extensions. Can you see Kotlin Android extensions? Just click on that right over here, click on that, just go on scrolling. So what it does is that you don't need to even write this code, right? Val btn, okay, even you don't need to write this thing. So how that thing will work, let me show you. Just get this plugin over here, extensions, Android extensions, get that extensions. Visit your Gradle file over here, your module Gradle file, and into that Gradle file add one more thing, Kotlin Android extension. Sync the project, and here you will find some very fancy features of the programming language. See, you just need to import this thing, right? Synthetic properties. It is converting and import all widget properties for a specific layout. I'll show you. Means what they are saying, that if you want to convert any or all the properties of this particular layout, you are going to use our package, this package. Let me copy this thing, import this, and I'm going to paste it over here. Let me import everything from which layout. I'm going to say activity underscore main layout, import everything from this layout. So if you have imported the synthetic package, right, then you don't need to have this line as well. So everything from that package would be automatically imported. Everything from that package would be automatically imported. So btn okay would be still referred to this button. If you want to check, let me run the code and show you what happens. Now see, still you'll find the welcome and other things would be working over here. See, that's working, but I have removed, what you can say, but I have removed this find view by ID, right? So likewise, Android now officially can be programmed into the Kotlin programming language. Many things are yet to come. You will find many libraries, many people are contributing on the GitHub, right? And seen in the future, might be getting changed. I hope you liked this tutorial. I'm coming with full-fledged tutorial on the Kotlin as well. So how Kotlin programming language works and what are the benefits of going with the Kotlin in the Android programming, right? That all that thing I'm going to cover in the tutorial, but this is just the introductory tutorial. I hope you'll like it. Kindly subscribe my channel, that is CodeKul. Remember the CodeKul. Thanks a lot for watching me, and remember that we are coming with lot many things, right? Lot many things with the Kotlin. Thanks a lot.